MC Rappaport. You ready? We're going to start this. Your first word is ambiguous.
Man, getting into this. Listen to my raps because they're mad ambiguous. It's ambiguously when you're coming and slammer. It's ambiguous like slelling when you got no grammar. It's ambiguous like I really got the flow. It's ambiguous like shit like you really don't know. Yeah, can they give it this? I don't know why I'm kicking this. What fucking word is this ambiguous? And I keep on shining.
I don't think I'd rate myself as one of the top battlers in this country just purely for the fact that I just don't enjoy it that much. I don't really like insulting people, and I don't think I'm very good at insulting people. My parents, they both, when I've showed them battles or when I've invited them to the battles I've been, they absolutely despise the insulting nature of such sort of establishments.
Hi, can you buzz us? Thanks.
But my grandmother is a poet, and she was very proud to see me in the paper for doing, you know, modern poetry.
I think it could be, although you haven't heard it.
I haven't heard it.
Honestly, no, you didn't hear it. Now, here's a chess verse with happy end. I'd lock myself out, as I do sometimes. And here we are. There was the hole, he had the key, and he knows how, believe you me. He tried and tried with all his might, yet there was something not quite right. I'm talking about your dad trying to get in, you see. I realized then, with quite a shock, he couldn't open that damned lock, so to the neighbors, Alex, Anne, come quickly please and help my man. Those dear people had a hunch. Call the locksmith, stay for lunch. My friends, our thanks are most sincere. Without your help, I greatly fear we would be standing evermore outside our bloody unit door. I'm sorry if I used the wrong word.
I love it.
I'm trying to rap, not trying to be a beginner on this very same table where I have Friday dinner. It's kind of nice, yes, I know that I'm hitting. Really love the taste of my grandma's chicken, and I taste it up every time that it's right. Chilling out here on a Friday night. So I keep on singing the songs, don't know if this is right or maybe it's wrong either way. Trying to feel like I'm able, rapping with my grandma at the kitchen table.
I think so.
Thank you. When a young person has something to say and it comes out unrehearsed, and that is the most powerful thing, that it comes out unrehearsed, it comes from here and from here. That's important.
Ambiguous like I really got the flow. It's ambiguous like shit like you really don't know. Yeah, can they give it this? I don't know why I'm kicking this. What fucking word is this ambiguous? And I keep on shining, kicking this topic. Yo, I'm fucking ambiguous, that's fucking drop it. I keep going and I'm fucking gonna sin it. It's ambiguous between 60 seconds and half a minute.
Time! Can we have MC Marksman to the stage? All right. Your word. You've got 60 seconds, MC Marksman, to rap about hallucinogens.
See no thugs on the mic, hallucinogens, who's doing fucking drugs tonight? You know, I rock it tight and I murder cats, hallucinogens. What type of word is that? You know, I'm about to disperse this, I make you nervous, hallucinogens get up your brain and they work it.
The point of battling to me is to get my name out, really. I don't even like battling that much, you know what I mean? I feel it's something that MCs need to do to prove themselves, to prove that they have the right to be on that platform doing what they're doing. Yeah, when I'm not MCing, I'm working away, still got to earn my way, unfortunately. I mean, I've been doing, you know, manual labour kind of stuff for a while now, since I left high school, you know what I mean, trying to make a bit of money. you know, this is the thing for me, then, you know, and this is what's going to take me out of there, then so be it. You know, I'd love that to be the thing.
It is life.
I guess the inspiration I get from sorting mail is don't give up music or you're going to be stuck sorting mail for the rest of your life.
Crush dudes, hallucinogens, someone give me some mushrooms. That's what I'm supposed to do. I'm over dudes because hallucinogens are only done by a choice of you.
Here we go. You ready?
Yep.
So I battle it out in this battle arena, no shadow of doubt that I have to be seen to get my point across. Rejoice with God and anoint the lost. Give him a reason for the spiritual meaning that everything in life is scripted to lead in towards a place.
I'm a Christian now, you know, I've found God. And I am a Christian.
Place, because one day we'll all be torn away, and it's up to you to trust the proof in the depths or are born and saved.
You know, it was just something I found in my life that was like, you know, made it better, made it worth living, because, you know, I went through a fair bit of turmoil, you know, in my younger years, smoked too much pot, you know, kind of went through a depression for a stage. I just kind of, you know, didn't leave the house. Having God with me, man, has just been a blessing, so, you know. It's been a good thing.
Lord, we also lift up our brother Cam. Lord, as he's going through some situations, Lord, we pray, Lord, that he's a believer, Lord, and we pray, Lord, that you'll continue to speak to him, and Lord, your Holy Spirit is a comforter, so we pray, Lord, that he'll get comfort from your Holy Spirit, from your word, and that they'll all come through these situations, Lord, testifying of your grace, Lord, and your love.
I'm screaming from American point of view, but this joint will do, anoint a few. Like the Lord in the sky, cause on the mic, man, I'll torture guys tonight. And I speak the statements, it's indeed the greatest. So you wanna say something back, you don't need to say it, yeah. I come with the highest caliber, I'm a rocket down to the camera.
There's a lot of Christian hip-hop heads in Australia, and they're looking for that place, you know. They don't necessarily fit with what regular churches are doing, and yet, you know, they wanna do hip-hop and God, and don't want those things to necessarily, you know, be apart from each other.
Hopefully, you know, this humble beginnings, hopefully hip-hop's a big movement and God is a big God. So if God's into things that we're doing, things are going to prosper, you know what I mean? Prosperity doctrine, no. But,
I don't want to get all preachy on this, you know what I mean? Everyone's going to be doing like, what you're doing, but when I first got into it, you know, I didn't want to say it to anyone, you know what I mean? It's kind of, because none of my family are or anything like that.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Especially in a battle, man. You go into a battle and they know that, they're just going to rip you to pieces. But, you know, hopefully now I've got, you know, I've come past that. I'm still not, you know, I'm still fairly new to the whole concept of it. But I'm just building on it, you know what I mean?
Lord, I lift your name on high.
We'd just like to say one thing before we worship the Lord. That God's got a filter up there, and to him, we sound, well, he sounds like Mariah Carey, but I sound like probably Michael Bolton with his hairstyle, and that we're both MCs, okay, so don't judge us, alright? And with
to me, man, it's just having God in my life, really, you know, God, Jesus, in my life, because when I didn't, you know, I felt like my life was going down the toilet, and now I do, it's just, you know, I'm in Sydney. You know, tomorrow night, and I feel I contribute a large part of that to having that influence in my life.
Damn, he's the best you ever heard in your life, cause I step up to murder the mic. One word of advice is don't step to me, cause I do this kind of unethically.
You know, I just try and keep it as witty as I can, try and keep, cause swearing's always a crutch, you know what I mean? I mean, sometimes there is an effective moment where it'll just be like, yeah, you hit him with that, dope, but I try and keep it out as much as I can, but you know, you'll see tomorrow night, man, like, it does slip, you know, it just can't help it, really. Because when you're going up there aggressive, you know, that's what's coming to your head. But, yeah.
So, let a couple slip.
Yeah, let a couple slip. Hopefully God's not going to strike me down, you know, the vengeance of God.
Into it, mate. Straight into it. These MCs have got to battle each other. No more lovely words for them.
Indeed. Make some noise if you want to hear these MCs battle. Come on.
As soon as they call your name, It's just straight into the zone, focused and ready to go into battle.
I get this little tingle and this little, all right, turn it on. Time to get in the ring.
Just complete satisfaction of versing another opponent and testing your freestyle skills against them.
I'll be in my own little hell, more stressed than I've ever been in my life. And then, you know, if I win the first battle or whatever, that's when you get even more nervous.
All right. Each MC is going to have 2 1-minute rounds.
Once you kick off, you're pretty much 100 miles and running, you know. You got it all behind you.
Let's see some guys spit fire at each other.
When they call your name, it's like, oh shit, who am I battling? Or if they call you up against someone you know you're gonna own, it's like, sweet, I'm gonna cane this dude. This guy's got nothing.
Go.
Hang on a second, I'm rocking a dream, dropping supreme. The only competition is on that fucking screen.
Australia, you're a failure, I'm telling you now. I freestyle up on the mic like you will never know how. Fever pressure, leave you feverish. Hell yeah, I tell you right now, I beat you up to this test. The freestyle master, that creates a disaster. I break your bones with your clones, leave your body in plaster.
Be the illest MC in your fucking vision. You can't make the cut like a circumcision. Check it out, I'm burning. Yo, this dude couldn't make the cut if he was a punk fucking surgeon.
I was like, nipples, what am I gonna say about that? I would have got to the battle, but I kept trying to wrap that nipples.
It's gonna be South Australia versus West Australia.
You think you're flowing it rough off the dome of the cuff? DC stands for disposable chump.
You know, even my fresh raps and press catcher couldn't make me look stupid in a celebrity death match. I'll get your head latched. I'm setting big steps. If you get to the States, they'll think Aussie's a dyslexic dickhead.
What's up now? You lost where it started. You come up on the mic, but your rap style's retarded. Get some raps before you try me. On the mic, me losing to you? Quite unlikely.
Good battle, MC Marksman, MC Purpose.
I had a few punchlines and whatnot, but I reckon, you know, I was messing up my flow a bit. I thought I could have hit more stuff and, you know, delivered it a bit better, but I didn't.
And once again, can we get MC Fever Preps representing Sydney, Australia, MC Rapper Boy?
The deal, his name is Rappaport. I attack your thought, no time to chat and talk. He's like a helpless astronaut, that's how ugly he is. When I grab the microphone, you know I'm crushing the mic.
Yeah, I'm like an astronaut, that verse is true. I need a fucking rocket ship to circle you. This shit rap, yo, I'm gifted with that, yo. It looks like somebody fucking pissed on your hat.
Hang on a second, I've got raw flows. He said someone pissed on my hat. Fuck it, I stole it from your wardrobe. So what's the deal when I'm killing ya? In this crowd, nobody is fucking feeling ya. Now hang on a second, I doubt you thought. Fuck Rappaport, I don't give a fuck about your hometown support.
Man, you know this fucking rap battle's complete. Honestly, you ain't going to USA, they're too cheap. They need 2 seats, one for each ass cheek. Man, it's fucking accusing. I'm fucking ripping this shit, get used to fucking losing.
Yeah.